Hi everyone, welcome to the .NET Core 3 tutorial. This is the first part of this series, and in this part we will learn what is .NET Core. If you are not new to the .NET, then you already know that there is already an existing framework which is called .NET framework. So we will learn what is the relationship of .NET Core with .NET framework, what all can we do with .NET Core, then we will learn what are the characteristics of .NET Core, and at the last we will see what all programming languages are supported in .NET Core. So let's start. First of all, let's understand what is .NET Core. This is the very short definition of .NET Core. .NET Core is a software development framework which is used to create multiple types of application. Okay, so if you need to create different type of applications, then you can work with .NET Core. What are the different type of applications, that we will see in the later part of this video. And now let's understand what is the relationship of .NET Core with .NET framework. .NET Core and .NET framework both are completely different framework. .NET Core is completely new written framework which does not have any dependency or relationship with .NET framework. Okay, so if you have worked on .NET framework, then you already know everything about the .NET framework. Now if we talk about the .NET Core, then this is not the next version of .NET framework. This is completely rewritten from scratch. .NET Core has different features, different characteristics than the .NET framework. .NET Core is the new and latest framework than the .NET framework. So .NET framework used to be the earlier part of the .NET world, and now all the development is happening on the .NET Core. So .NET Core is the new and the latest framework from the Microsoft. Now let's see what all can we do with .NET Core. .NET Core framework is used to create multiple types of application. This is not specific to only one type of application. With the help of .NET Core, you can create multiple types of application. There are multiple frameworks which are written on top of .NET Core to create different type of applications. So we can see that .NET Core is the root part for all other types of application. If we need to work with different applications, then we must know about the .NET Core. Now let's see what type of applications can we create with .NET Core 3. We can create console application, we can create web applications, and in the web applications we can create MVC template, we can create web API, we can create .NET Core with Angular, .NET Core with React.js. In the .NET Core 3, we can also create Windows application like the WPF and the WinForms. We can create the class library project. We can create test projects for the unit testing. We can also create some mobile applications for the Android, for iOS, and for the hybrid, etc. So these are some common type of applications that we can create with the help of .NET Core. Now the point is, why should we choose .NET Core? So to answer this question, let's understand what are the characteristics of .NET Core. Open source. .NET Core is an open source which is developed and maintained by Microsoft and developers all around the world on GitHub. If you know about the .NET framework, then .NET framework was not open source. Okay, but .NET Core is completely open source. It means you can see what all code is available behind the .NET Core framework. You can download all the code from the GitHub. This is the URL for the GitHub. Also, you can contribute to this URL. If you need to change something, then you can contribute on this repository. The second one is cross-platform. .NET works on Windows, macOS, and Linux operating system with same behavior, including 64-bit, 86-bit, and the ARM. If you are working with the .NET framework, then you already know that the development was possible only on the Windows operating system. Now with the help of .NET Core, we can develop our applications on any operating system: Windows operating system, Mac OS, Linux operating system, and even there is no any boundation of the bit. You can work on 6486 and the ARM. Command line tool. .NET Core fully supports command line tool, also called as CLI, which is useful in complete cycle of development. In the .NET Core, you can do all the steps which are required in the development with the help of CLI. For examples, if you need to create a new project, then you simply can do it with the help of CLI. You need to add some packages, you need to build your solution, or you need to run your solution. These are some small examples. There are a lot of things which we can do with the help of CLI in the .NET Core world. The next is deployment. If you are working with a .NET framework, then you already know that the .NET framework application can only be deployed on the IIS server. Now, there is no dependency on the IIS server. If you are working with the .NET Core, then you can deploy your application on the IIS, Linux, and even with the Dockers and lot more. It can be used with .NET framework, Xamarin, and Mono via .NET standards. So if you need to use .NET Core with your old .NET framework, then you can do that. You can use .NET Core in the Xamarin. You can use .NET Core in the Mono, but you have to follow some standards, which are the .NET standards. If you follow those rules, then you can use .NET Core in the .NET framework. Free of cost. So .NET Core is available as free of cost with MIT license. It is available on the GitHub and the license is MIT. It means you can use this framework for your private application development and for the commercial application development, and everything is completely free of cost. Now the main point is, what programming languages are supported in the .NET Core? Let's have a look. .NET Core supports following programming languages. First one is C#. If you are good in the C#, then everything which is available in the C#, you can use those things in the .NET Core framework in any application. The next is F#. If you are not good in the C# and want to use F# in your application, then you can use F# in the .NET Core application. And the third one is the Visual Basic. If you want to develop your application in the Visual Basic, then you can develop that as well. That's all in this part. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.